let's review our top three today. Perez, Russell and Charles Leclerc. With qualifying wrapped up now, we have our grid lineup for the big race and we missed Albert Park. So welcome back and it's great to be back in Melbourne. Welcome to the Australian Grand Prix. We go racing today then in the state of Victoria, where the drivers have 14 corners and 3.28 miles to navigate at an average lap speed of around 120 miles per hour. Close proximity of the barriers make accidents inevitable. Recent history shows us that a safety car is not at all out of the question. It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Sergio Perez will lead us away from pole position, just ahead of George Russell, who starts this event from P2. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Leclerc, Hamilton, Sainz, Verstappen, Fernando Alonso, Norris, Moore, Joe, Ocon, Gasly, Magnussen, Bottas, Stroll, Oscar Piastri, Tsunoda, Hülkenberg, Albon, and Logan Sargeant. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. Natalie Pinkham joins me once again in the commentary box. It's fantastic to have you with us today. I'm curious though, how do you think the drivers stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, the regulations aren't new anymore, but the teams and the drivers are still coming to terms with them. I firmly believe it's also track specific. We've seen some wheel-to-wheel racing throughout the year. Some tracks lend themselves better to it than others. I'd like to see it at every race in the whole season. Is that too much to ask?
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. Okay, so our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of this lap. Decent parking. Let's try and get a good launch as the lights go out. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with... Okay, we're monitoring somewhere on the internal combustion engine. Be aware that we're going to start to see a loss of power. Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
We've witnessed some great battles on the streets of Melbourne today then, and they've taken a fantastic win. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, confidence breeds confidence. Success breeds success. They are very much enjoying a purple patch right now.
Here come our winners now. A thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Max Verstappen seemed to just effortlessly weave through the other drivers today without a care in the world. He was definitely my driver of choice.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. Well, what an end to another fantastic...
Thank you. okay?
But we're about to go through the application process. We'll have a look at this for the next Grand Prix.
I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need to tell the team what to redevelop via the R&D screen.